Dunder method, short for double underscore method, are special methods in Python identified by their name enclosed in double underscore at the beginning and end, such as underscore underscore init underscore underscore or underscore underscore str underscore underscore. These methods play a crucial role in defining how objects behave in various contexts. In this video, we will be looking into their use, common implementation, best practices, and consideration. Dunder methods are also known as magic method or operator method because they are invoked automatically by the interpreter when certain operations or expressions are evaluated. For example, the underscore underscore len underscore underscore method is called when the len function is applied to an object. And the underscore underscore eq underscore underscore method is called when the equal equal operator is used between two objects. Dunder methods can be implemented to customize the behavior and functionality of user-defined classes. They allow programmers to define how objects of their classes interact with built-in functions, operators, and keywords. This customization enhances the readability and expressiveness of your code, making it more aligned with Pythonic conventions. We have already seen two Dunder methods, the underscore underscore init underscore underscore for object initialization, and the underscore underscore str underscore underscore, creating a human readable string representation. Dunder method should be implemented when you want to define custom behavior for your class instances. For example, you can implement the commonly used Dunder method underscore underscore wrapper underscore underscore to provide a representation for debugging. We've seen the underscore underscore eq underscore to customize equality comparison. The underscore underscore ne underscore underscore to implement inequality comparison. In addition, if you would like to use a custom class as in a set or as dictionary keys, you must implement the underscore underscore hash underscore underscore, enabling instances to be used as dictionary keys. Indexable classes provide a familiar and intuitive interface for accessing elements within instance of a class. By implementing Dunder method associated with indexing, we can make our classes behave like sequences or containers, opening up a myriad of possibilities for efficient data manipulation. To create indexable classes, you must implement the following Dunder method. GetItem, this method defines the behavior of accessing an element at a specific index using square bracket notation. It should return the value associated with the given index. SetItem, for mutable indexable classes, this method allows us to set the value at a particular index. It is invoked when we use the assignment operator with square bracket notation. DelItem, when an element is removed using the del statement on square bracket notation, this method is called to handle the deletion of the specified index. For example, consider a class representing a simplified version of a DVD catalog. In this example, we've defined the getItem, setItem, and delItem to provide the indexable behavior of our DVD catalog class. Additionally, the len is implemented to allow the use of the built-in function len. And wrapper is included for readable representation of the object. To use this class, we can now use indices to access specific DVD in the catalog. On line 8, we use the len function to get the number of DVDs in the catalog. The call len myDVDs automatically invokes the Dunder method underscore underscore len underscore underscore and executes it. On line 10, the statement print index plus 1 comma myDVDs index invokes the get item, and on line 12, myDVDs square bracket 0 equal Monty Python on the holy grail invokes the set item. Finally, on line 30, the del myDVDs at position 2 calls the Dunder method delItem. Executing this code result in the program output shown here. As you can see, implementing this dunder method makes your class behave like sequences. It enhances the readability and expressiveness of your code, making it more aligned with Pythonic convention. Iterable classes allow us to traverse their element in a systematic way, providing a natural integration with Python iteration protocol. By implementing dunder method associated with iteration, we can make our class behave like built-in iterable types, such as list or tuples. To create iterable classes, the following two methods should be implemented. Iter, this method defines how an instance of the class should behave when an iterator is requested. It should return an iterator object, which implements the underscore underscore next underscore underscore method. For iterable classes, this method is called to retrieve the next element in the iteration. It should raise stop iteration when there are no more elements to iterate. Iter and next together form the basis of the iterator protocol, allowing instances of our class to seamlessly integrate with Python iteration construct like for loops. Let's revisit our previous class DVD catalog. We can expand our class functionality to allow iterating through all the DVDs in the catalog. First, we need to define on line 27 an attribute currentIndex storing the current position in our iteration. Every time an iterator is requested, the iter method is called and the currentIndex is set to 0. The method next on line 30 is called to get the next item in the iteration. If the currentIndex is smaller than the length of the list of movies, it means the iteration is not finished yet. We must return the movie at position currentIndex and increment the currentIndex by 1. On line 36, the currentIndex exceeds the length of the list, and therefore there are no more movies to iterate through. The method should raise the stop iteration exception to signal the end of iteration as per the Python iterator protocol. We can now use an instance of our class within a for loop as shown in the code here. On line 20, the statement for movie in my DVDs invokes the iter method to request an iterator. Then the next method is called to assign the movie at index 0 to the variable movie. At the end of each iteration, that is after the print statement on line 21 is executed, the next method is called again. The process repeats until the method next raises the stop iteration exception. Comparable classes enable us to establish a meaningful order among instances of a class. This is particularly useful when sorting or searching through collection of objects. By implementing dunder method related to comparison, we can customize the behavior of this operator based on the attribute of our class instances. Here are the key dunder methods for comparable classes. The equality operator can be customized by defining this method. It returns true if the current instance is equal to the other instance, and false otherwise. The less than operator is defined by implementing this method. It returns true if the current instance is less than the other instance and false otherwise. Similar to the LT method, this method defines the less than or equal to operator. The greater than operator is implemented by defining this method. It returns true if the current instance is greater than the other instance and false otherwise. Similar to greater than, this method defines the greater than or equal to operator. Let's consider a simple class representing Roman numerals. The class has one class attribute, RomanMap, a dictionary to map some integers to their Roman numeral counterpart, and one instance attribute, an int named value, representing the Roman numeral value in the decimal base. On line 7, The dunder method in it initializes an instance with an int that is the decimal representation of the Roman numeral. On line 10, the method toRoman returns a string representing the decimal value as a Roman numeral. Finally, to provide an ordering of the Roman numeral, we implement the sixth method used for comparison. To compare two Roman numerals, we compare the value attribute of each object, that is, the ordering of decimal numbers. If you look closely, the last for comparison method uses __EQ_LT_ in a Boolean expression. For example, on line 36, greater or equal operator is expressed as self is equal to other or self is not less than other. Having implementing this six dunder method for comparison, we can use the Python comparison operators to compare two instances of Roman numeral. The code is easier to implement and read. The expressiveness of the class is improved. Dunder methods should be implemented with care on following some best practices. For example, you should follow the principle of least astonishment. Dunder methods should behave in a way that is consistent with the built-in type on the Python language semantics. For example, the EQ method should return a Boolean value, not raise an exception or modify the object state. In addition, you should respect the reflexivity, symmetry, and transitivity properties. The equality and inequality comparison should be reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Similarly, the ordering comparison should be reflexive, antisymmetric, and transitive. If a class defines the equal method, it should also define the not equal method. To ensure that the inequality comparison works as expected, the simplest way to do this is to use the @functools.totalOrderingDecorator. The functools.totalOrderingDecorator can automatically generate the other rich comparison method, less or equal, greater than equal, based on a few specified methods, usually equal and less than. This reduces boilerplate code as demonstrated on the refactored implementation of our class Roman numeral, where only the equal and less than have been implemented. Nonetheless, the other comparators are still working as shown in the code snippet here. Use operator overloading sparingly. Dunder method can be used to overload operator and provide syntactic sugar for common operation. However, this should not be abused or misused, as it can make the code less readable or intuitive. Operator overloading should only be used when it makes sense for the domain or problem at hand, and when it follows the established convention and expectation of Python programmers. In conclusion, dunder methods form a crucial aspect of Python object-oriented programming paradigm. These special methods, identified by their names enclosed with in __ at the beginning and end, provide a mechanism for defining customized behavior in classes. Dunder methods are often referred to as magic methods or operator methods due to their automatic invocation by the Python interpreter during specific operation or expression. By implementing this method, developers can tailor the behavior of their class to seamlessly integrate with built-in function, operator, and Pythonic convention. A few words of caution though. Clear documentation of dunder method implementation is crucial for understanding their purpose and usage. Not all dunder methods need to be implemented in every classes. The choice of which dunder method to implement depends on the specific requirement of the class and its intended use. Overloading too many operators or using dunder method inappropriately can lead to code that is difficult to maintain and understand, which defeats the purpose of such method. Consistent use of dunder method contributes to a more predictable and maintainable codebase. Incorporating dunder method into your classes empowers you to create more flexible, intuitive, and Pythonic code. By adhering to best practices, documenting your implementation logic, and considering the context of your application, you can make the most of Dunder method to enhance the functionality and readability of your Python programs. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.